But mostly the little things that come in between the big ones, like falling asleep next to one another, making them drinking Cooler Light, using the sun, in the valley, spending time with the Ozarks, family, going on Cousins Mojo, and just being in the big hug from another people. These everyday moments fused together in one big experience. And even though this experience is so incredible, words fail us when we try and explain it. But trying to describe love is one of those favorite pastimes. We use the words, we act like stories, poems, songs, all about love. And even though we describe love in different ways, and even though love can look different from one person to the next, we all know it when we see it. We see it. So today, we have some words from loved ones, about love, and from people of who knows. The first reading is from the First Corinthians 13, verses 1 through 3. I speak in tongues of men or of angels, but do not have love, and only a resounding gospel for a clean world. If I have a gift of prophecy and cannot fathom the mysteries of all knowledge, and if I have faith that can move mountains, but do not have love, I have nothing. If I give, I have to possess the poor and give over my body to hardship that I may boast, but I do not have love. Love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it's not proud. It is not dishonor others, it's not self-seeking, and it's not easily angered. It keeps no records or wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always preserves. Love. Prior to the vows, we shall take a moment to recognize marriage is not only the joining of you two, it's also the joining of two families. Being able to spend some time with both families last night at the rehearsal dinner, you can see many similarities in the care, support, and love that you see both of your families. The foundation is important now, and more important now than it's ever been, and this support must be extended to one another. Tony and Dan, you are not losing a son, but gaining a daughter. You promise to love and support Wayne as you would your own. Greg and Jim, you're not losing a daughter, but gaining a son. You promise to love and support Nick as you would your own. Lenny and Nick, you fell in love by chance, but you're here today because of your choice. You both are choosing each other. You chose to be with someone who enhances you, makes you think, makes you smile, and makes every day brighter. You're about to make promises to each other that you intend to keep. You're going to vow to take each other, to stand up for one another in my happiness. There's a simple premise each one of these promises make. You're vowing to be there for each other. Nick, are you ready to enter into marriage with Wayne, believing this love you two share, and your faith in each other will endure all things? Wayne, are you ready to enter into this marriage with Nick, believing the love you two share, the faith you enter, Lady and Nick, please face each other and recite the vows.
Over the past few years, we have become a best friend, a source of reason, and at times my greatest challenge. Above all else, we have become a loved one, and driving the force of time with every step I take. Our day goes by in something special. Whether it's through beauty, and intelligence, and watch or not, we never any sorts of that. And it's this one that made me want to take to the top of the mountain. I had all day before made our way to the feet, but I knew perfect what to say. When I got there, on the top of the world, all I could do was look at you and smile. Without anything or nothing, whichever it was. So, because of this, I'm at the top of the mountain. I can't find myself all the time, I don't know what to say.
To all of you may pursue physically, mentally, and directly. My favorite thing about you is that your career was really nice and rich, and for every new idea about making a movie, I was like, wow, before I asked you to call. And like, you're much the same way you refer to you than you do in the song.
You both have chosen to wear rings as a reminder of these priorities. People often say wedding bands are a perfect circle with no beginning and no end. But these rings did have a beginning. Stones were formed a long time ago beneath the earth, probably outside the mountains of Vancouver. Eventually, a series of lucky events caused them to rise to the surface of someone dug them up. Adam liquefied, molded them, cooled them, and polished them to form what they are today. In reality, something beautiful was made from the rock elements. Love is like that. It comes from humble beginnings, and through a combination of serendipity and effort, and perfect being shaped into something extraordinary. The process of making something beautiful, where there's once nothing at all. As you look at these rings over the years, I hope you remember that. You created something valuable. And just as I know, you'll protect these rings. I'm confident that you will, and protect the commitments you're about to make. Place this on Lane's finger, please repeat after me. With this ring, I marry you and bind my life to yours. It's a symbol of my eternal love, my everlasting friendship, and the promise of all my tomorrows. As you place this ring on Nick's finger, please repeat after me. With this ring, I marry you and bind my life to yours. It's a symbol of my eternal love, my everlasting friendship, and the promise of all my tomorrows. I would like to invite Nick's mama to provide the blessing for this marriage.
Love is an adventure, like the air journey. Love is an adventure and a conquest that survives and develops like the universe itself, only by perpetual discovery. The only right love is that between couples whose passion leads them both, one to the other, to a higher potential for being. Put your faith in the spirit which dwells between the two of you. You have each offered yourself to the other as a boundless field of understanding, of enrichment, of mutually increased sensibility. You will meet above all by entering to and sharing one another's thoughts, affections, and dreams. There alone, as you know the spirit, which is arrived through the flesh, you will find your disappointments and limits. There alone, the skies are open for your love. There alone, lies a great romance.
Let us pray. Lord, may this couple remember when they first met the strong love that grew between them. Help them to see the good in each other and to find the answers to problems as they arise. Help them to say the kind and loving things to each other and continue this beautiful relationship. Help them to understand humility and be big enough to seek forgiveness. And finally, help them to understand that their marriage is now in your hands and in your blessing. Amen. This unity ceremony represents the flowing of two lives into a single stream. Vodka and olive juice hold their separate purposes, but when poured together or shaken up a little, they never be separate. It would be impossible to ever be separate or pull apart these exact drops that once belonged to each other. The blending of the drinks represents a union not only of them, but their friends and families as well. The separate glasses, once poured together, can never be put back into their separate. They are forever entwined, just as the lives and loves of my family. Now, by the power vested in me by the church and the state of Illinois, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Nick, you may kiss the bride. Congratulations. It's now my pleasure to introduce to you, for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Nicholas Whittingham.